Good morning students. Today we are going to learn about crystal field theory. What is crystal field theory? Before we get into crystal field theory, we must see about assumptions of CFT. The central metal cation is surrounded by ligand which contain one or more lone pair of electrons. What is meant by ligand? Ligand means an atom or group of atoms which can donate a pair of electron to central metal cation. Next assumption is the ionic ligand. Example, fluoro, chloro are regarded as point charges, and neutral molecules, example H2O ammonia, are regarded as point dipoles. Third assumption is the electrons of ligand does not enter metal orbitals, thus there is no orbital overlap takes place. Fourth assumption of CFT is the bonding between metal and ligand is purely electrostatic. So this is an example for octahedral complex. An octahedral complex means metal atoms at the center, there are six ligands are approaching metal in X, Y and Z coordinates. So these are d orbitals of central metal atom. Out of 5 d orbitals, these 3 d orbitals are said to be non-axial orbitals. Non-axial orbitals means they are having lobes in between the axes. That means they are called triply degenerate orbitals. Triply degenerate means these 3 orbitals are having equal energy. And these 2 orbitals are having lobes along the axis. That is, they are called axial orbitals. This picture represents d orbital splitting of metal orbital metal. When ligands are approaching metal, when the ligands are approaching metal atom, there will be electrostatic attractive force between metal and negatively charged ligands. But when ligands approaching closer and closer, there will be a repulsive force between metal and ligand. So this is ground state electronic configuration of central metal atom. When the ligands started to approach the metal, the energy of metal d orbital increases. So this is excited state or configuration of metal. When ligands approaching metal, the repulsive force will be existing. There are 2 different types of repulsive force. Since the EG orbitals are having lobes along the axis and ligands also approaching metal along the axis, so these 2 orbitals are experiencing greater repulsive force. So energy of these 2 d orbitals will be increased. The T2G orbitals are having lobes in between the axes, so they will be experiencing less repulsive force, so the energy of these three orbitals decreases. So when the ligands are approaching metal, the 2 sets of d orbitals are experiencing 2 different repulsive forces. This is T2G whose energy is decreased. This is EG whose energy is increased. The energy gap between T2G and EG orbital is said to be delta O. That is crystal field stabilization energy. 0.4 delta O is magnitude of decrease in energy of T2G orbital, and 0.6 delta O is increase in energy of EG orbital. So the energy gap is the sum of energy decrease and energy increase. Thank you, girls.